But first, a fugitive now sits behind bars. I'm Paul Folger.
Good evening. I'm Jessica Schambach. Our cameras were rolling as Adam Rollins was led into the Seminole County Jail. He's accused of killing his girlfriend. Eyewitness News 5's Carla Wade is live now with this big story. And Carla, Rollins has been on the run for days.
That's right, Jessica. Authorities have been looking for him since last Thursday, and that is when they found his girlfriend shot to death inside the trailer where they live together. Now, the U.S. Marshal who caught up with him today tells us that basically he saw Rollins walking. He was not hiding in the woods, and that he was very dehydrated from the heat, and that he wanted to be seen and turn himself in. Can you tell us what happened?
Looking disheveled, gaunt, and with hair that appears to have been bleached, a U.S. Marshal led a handcuffed Adam Rollins into the Seminole County Jail just before 6 o'clock.
Are you innocent?
Clutching a bottle of water.
Is there anything you'd like to say?
The 28-year-old man, wanted for questioning in the death of his girlfriend, kept his head down and did not answer any questions in front of our cameras.
I thought they would catch him before this, actually.
And investigators thought they had come close once before. A SWAT team surrounded this house in Paul's Valley on Friday after getting a tip that Rollins was inside. But once they searched the home, he was nowhere to be found. Today, investigators say they found Rollins hiding in the woods just off of Interstate 35 near the Winniewood exit in Garvin County. The trailer where police say 24-year-old Shiloh Mitchell was found shot to death has since been removed from this property and stored as evidence. A friend who found Mitchell's bloody body and 2-month-old child nearby but unharmed says Rollins needs to explain what happened inside their home.
Why? I mean, she's got 4 or 3 beautiful little girls that need their mother, and she was only 24. I mean, she didn't deserve this.